School principals and administrators have all been criminally charged. Why? Because they allowed a predator teacher to continue to abuse minors in their school. Let's put up his picture full mass. I'm taking you to a place called Plymouth, Connecticut. Three school principals and one teacher each face criminal charges after allegedly failing to report to proper authorities student and parent sexual abuse complaints about another elementary school teacher. One time fourth grade teacher, James Eschert, 51 years of age, was charged in January with 5 counts of risk of injury to a child, all felonies by the way, and 2 counts of fourth degree sexual assault. Those were misdemeanors. So let's talk about this person and the enablers around him. Court records suggest offense dates of 2016, 2017, 2019 for this teacher's alleged in-class conduct. A detailed affidavit alleges that he recommended or selected certain girls to join his fourth grade class and then allegedly allowed a list of favorites to remain in his classroom during recess. He then allegedly gave those girls and answers to test questions. The teacher then allegedly touched a thigh and an arm and is accused of bouncing several of the girls on his lap in a humping motion. According to court records, several of the accusers reported that this teacher became erect in their presence. Among other things, the teacher also took sexualized photos of the girls while they were in school. A camera recovered by the authorities is said to have revealed 26 inappropriate images. 2 of the pictures allegedly showed a close-up of a female student's groin area while she was performing a cartwheel. 3 images were taken from ground level and showed female students seated in a manner which exposed their groin and underwear. That's in the affidavit. Let's put up the other educators here, okay? 4 other educators were arrested this month in connection with the case. The school's most recent principal, Sherry Turner, retired principal, Kristen Collins, one-time acting principal, second grade teacher, Melissa Morelli, and Rebecca Holleran, math interventionist, are all charged with failing to report the abuse, neglect, or injury to a child, or the imminent risk of serious harm to a child. Or in other words, the police said they swept it under the rug. See, while many conservatives will tell you that the real problem in K-12 education is critical race theory, which isn't even taught, or it's wokeness, which is insanity, right? Woke is a good thing. It means you're not asleep. They won't tackle real predators and monsters like this. You see, to me, those who enabled this are just as guilty as the man who did it. Ben, thoughts on this?
Yeah, I mean, to tie in what you're saying, like one of the things that Republicans always get super, super angry about is any notion of teaching like kids in school notions of consent, right? They seem to get like deeply outraged at even just like the most entry level stuff. So like kids know how to communicate this stuff to like their parents and stuff. And you wonder why. Well, it's things like this. And the fact that there were like so many administrators and like other teachers that weren't speaking up about this, like everything about this. I mean, fourth grade, what are you, 8 years old in fourth grade? Like this is just like, I mean, there are really no words. There are really no words because everything about this is just like deeply, deeply shocking and just like speaks to a whole working culture that is just, I mean, downright evil. Like seriously, what's going on at that school?
Yeah, it's extreme. And I want to remind everyone that it was a policy movement in this country to get rid of classes that taught kids the difference between good touch, bad touch, appropriate, inappropriate. Republicans said that was too age inappropriate to teach a child good touch, bad touch. Well, we wouldn't have to if we didn't have monsters like this inside of our school system.